Everyone, this is a story about the most terrifying sleep paralysis experience I have ever had in my entire life. And to give you a clue as to the level of fear I had, my first ever sleep paralysis experience, I hallucinated the girl from the ring crawling up the foot of my bed until she was in front of my face and just screaming. This story was way more terrifying than that. I explained this story on Twitch, and if you want to be there on Twitch when I'm talking about stuff that I've experienced or whatnot, head over to twitch.tv/GizEdwards. Follow me on there. It's a good time, good experience, good little community we have there. But the story, I need to give you a little context. So a little background information, which will lead up to this story. So, about 2 years ago, I realized that I was an addict, but not an addict for drugs or alcohol or anything like that. I was a sugar addict, specifically fizzy drinks. I tried to give up fizzy drinks before in the past, and lo and behold, nothing happened. And I realized very quickly that I am an all or nothing kind of person. Either I quit cold turkey and never have fizzy drinks ever again, or I, you know, just carry on. But considering I was drinking anywhere between 2 and 4 liters of fizzy drinks every single day, which for you Americans out there is about, that's anywhere between 70 and 140 ounces every day, I needed to do something about it. I was heading for diabetes. There's no question. If I didn't stop, it would be diabetes. So I gave up in February. And instantly I had withdrawals from not drinking sugar and caffeine, ultimately. And it was pretty bad. I had instant headaches, I had aversion to lights, my muscles were aching, my joints were aching, everything was in pain, and I just was not feeling great at all. To top it off, I caught a cold because of this. So my body was in shock or something from like cold turkey, and then I like must have knocked my immune system down or something, and I caught a cold and I was experiencing all this, but it was hyper sensed, so like everything was more painful and like joints were hurting, the light was hurting my eyes, and I had headaches even worse than before, which would have been fine, but then because of that knocked my immune system down even further and I caught the flu. And it's one of my pet peeves when people say that they caught the flu, but what they actually mean is they had a really bad cold. I hate that stuff. I really do. But I caught the flu. And the flu, if you have it, it will knock you. Like, I was bedbound for like a week. Solid. It's a good job I wasn't doing anything at the time. But yeah, that was a pretty bad month. My symptoms lasted a whole month. But when I caught the flu, I had extra symptoms on top of the headaches and the muscle pains and stuff. I had sweats. I would sweat uncontrollably. In nighttime, in the daytime, whatever, I would sweat. And I also had cold flushes, hot flushes. But the worst symptom of all of it, the worst was it felt like my skin was constantly being electrocuted. I don't exactly know what it is or why, but I couldn't touch my own skin. Otherwise it would hurt. Like, it felt like I was being electrocuted. People couldn't touch my skin because it felt like I was being electrocuted. But it didn't just stop at people and skin. Like, I couldn't wear clothes properly, or when I did, it hurt. Because it would be touching my skin. If I was lying in bed, I'd be in pain because my skin was touching the bed. The duvet, everything. Just painful. I went for a walk with some of my friends when I was in this peak of my illness. And to this day, he says he's never seen anybody who looked more ill than me. So, and I don't even remember going for the walk properly. Through the whole month, I remember three things. I remember going to a meeting with my accountant. I remember briefly going on that walk with my friends. And then I remember this story, the sleep paralysis story. all of these combined illnesses and things made my sleeping pattern awful. I'd wake up during the night because I was hot and sweaty. I'd fall back to sleep just from exhaustion and just, you know, I had the flu. And then I'd wake up later and the sweat had turned to ice and I was freezing cold. And then I woke up because of a headache, or I woke up because of a sore back, or I woke up because of my skin touching something. And it was just awful. And anybody who's experienced sleep paralysis will know that a sleep paralysis experience is more likely to happen if you have a broken sleeping pattern, which is exactly what I had. And here was the story. I go to sleep and I wake up and I am swarmed with this feeling, this sense of dread, more than I've ever felt in my life. And I've had a lot of experiences with sleep paralysis because of lucid dreaming. But I've never in my life felt anything quite to this scale. I don't know if it was because I was ill or whatever. I would hazard a guess it was. And I'm terrified. And I open my eyes, and standing around the perimeter of my bed, shoulder to shoulder, are hooded figures, kind of like Eyes Wide Shut, you know, standing around my bed, all looking at me. I couldn't see their faces. I couldn't see anything like that would distinguish them to be human. And that's the thing that terrified me the most, is because I opened my eyes, and even though I know it's sleep paralysis, I was not with it at all because of this illness. And I wake up and I look, and they're standing shoulder to shoulder. There's not a gap where somebody else could stand. I'm just surrounded by these cloaked figures. And for whatever reason, I knew wholeheartedly these were not human figures. I knew from the core of my being that these were all demons. And the reason they were here is because they were waiting for me to die so that they could take me to hell. And I knew it. Obviously, as a rational person, hindsight, obviously they weren't demons. I hallucinated these figures. But at the time, in the moment when I'm super ill, these were demons. They were coming to take me to hell. There was nothing I could have done about it. I just had to hope that I wouldn't die. And the thing was, even though I knew they were demons, and I knew they were coming to take me, and I knew that I was at the whim of fate, I didn't care at the time. Did not care. I woke up, looked around, terrified, knew they were demons, knew they were coming to reap my soul, take me to hell, and let me burn in anguish to eternity. But I was alright with that. And I know this might sound anticlimactic, especially when you compare it to the story about the girl from the ring. But this was by far the most terrifying experience I've had. And it was the worst sleep paralysis experience I had. Not because of the fact that I was okay with dying, but for the fact that combined with an illness and obviously hallucinations, this was the worst. I knew they were demons, and I was in a bad place. I woke up the next day after falling asleep again, obviously. But nothing really had changed. I think I had a couple more sleep paralysis experiences during the illness, but nothing that I can remember because I was very, very, very ill. And for the first time in my life, I understand the comments on my sleep paralysis videos. like often when I look at my videos that have had, in which I talk about sleep paralysis, I get like comments after comments after comments saying, oh, these aren't hallucinations, these are demons. And if you just like say the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, they'll go away and he'll protect you. I fully understand why people think that. For the first time ever. Before, I was like, no, it's definitely hallucination. And I'm still like, it's definitely hallucinations. Don't get me wrong. But I fully understand why people think it's demons and why people want to go with Jesus in this period of time. Because if I was a religious man, of which I'm not, but if I were a religious man, I would probably have cried out for Jesus to help at that point. Other than my nihilistic view of just, yeah, whatever, just take me into hell. It was bad. So that's my story. The worst sleep paralysis experience I've ever had. It's by far the most terrified I've ever been. Just trying to think if that's true. That is true. And I hope I never experience anything like that again. Now, it's your turn. Tell me what your sleep paralysis experiences were in the comments below. I will look forward to reading them. So until next time, bye!